one goes out to anyone who feels too average.
This clip is from the movie Carrie, released in 1976. In this scene, Carrie, a shy, sort of weird social outcast, is about to be crowned prom queen. Little does she know, popular girl Chris Hargensen is about to pull a nasty prank on her. Once she's announced as prom queen, this bucket of pig's blood is going to spill all over Carrie, humiliating her in front of the whole school. If you thought I'd relate to Chris, you'd be dead wrong. If you thought I'd relate to Carrie, you'd also be wrong. I relate to her. Who's that, you ask? Exactly. For as long as I can remember, I've played the role of average. Average social life, average grades, and when I graduated college, I interviewed for average jobs. Hold on, there's nothing wrong with this lifestyle. The problem was, it wasn't mine.
See, for a long time, I played the role of average because I was used to being below average. I grew up pretty poor. I lived with my mom, my dad, my sister in a small two-bedroom apartment. Oh yeah, and my mom's brothers and sisters and their family were there too. So at about one point, there were probably 10 people in one house, sharing one bathroom. Eventually, my family moved into a nice middle-class home, but that mentality stayed. That mentality of, why are you chasing dreams when you have to survive? But maybe I could do both. I could chase dreams and be responsible.
But if you live your life according to how others feel like it should be lived and balance that with how you want it to be, your time is so limited, you never get good at anything. You become average.
I hope nobody saw that.
The person who is dedicated to living the way they want fully will outpace you every single time. And I chose to be average because everyone else did it, and it was safer because I saw it work for them. The problem is, they don't make movies about average. But that feeling of, this is not what you're supposed to be doing, kept screaming louder and louder in my ear. Me being unhappy was life's way of saying, wake up!
And so, I did. Really, Wynn? Really? Come on.
I wish I could say that I dropped everything to pursue a life of filmmaking, but I had student loans to pay, and I needed a job. I hate to admit it, but I'm not good at a lot of things. Cooking? Forget about it. Academics? I wish. Athletics? Okay, that's embarrassing.
I can't put that in there.
Average. Push-ups. For women.
But there's one thing I'm confident in doing, telling a story using video. But who would hire someone with zero experience? Sure, I took a couple of film classes, I've made videos ever since I was in the fourth grade using Movie Maker, but that's it. So I started from the bottom, still not at the top yet.
Welcome to Psych IRL, my name is Donna and this is a fake video I'm shooting.
I made videos on YouTube because it was free, and then I emailed every single company near me and told them I'd work for free just to get my foot in the door. Used my YouTube channel to show them what I could do. There were a lot of no's, but eventually someone said yes. And as time went on, that free work turned into paid work. And people all around the world started noticing my YouTube channel. I started to grow. They finally wanted to hear what I had to say. The story was about me. So if you're too scared and too worried about your story being average, don't be. So what if your life doesn't seem as heroic as Oprah Winfrey? So what if it doesn't seem as glamorous as Paris Hilton's? Humans have been on this planet for ages until disease or a supernova wipes us out. And in that speck of time that you've been alive, no one will ever have the same story as you.
Whether you share that story with 1 or 1 million, you owe it to the world to share you.
My story hasn't ended yet. What's yours?